And in recent weeks, we have been reporting on soaring home prices and rising rents. It's hitting renters especially hard because it hurts them immediately. Now, consumer reporter John Matarese gets the other side of the story so you don't waste your money.
It's not just home prices that are soaring this year. Rents are going up too. But now we're hearing from a landlord as to the reasons why. Amanda Barger was evicted earlier this year after she was unable to pay her rising rent.
I know this is a business, but they could have a little, you know, kindness.
Barbara Hill Kelly's rent was raised over $100 a month at her apartment.
$117 to be exact.
Per month.
Per month.
Stories like this can make landlords look like the boogeyman, but several have now contacted me to say it's been a difficult year for them with rising water bills and property taxes and many tenants who couldn't pay their rent.
We struggled along with everybody else during the pandemic.
Deborah Collins manages 25 apartments and rental homes. She says many landlords lost income last year.
We canceled all late fees for the year. We worked on different payment plans for any residents who were behind.
The eviction moratorium, she says, meant landlords had to allow tenants to go months without paying rent.
A lot of housing providers are looking for ways to try and recoup those losses and are possibly doing it in large rental price hikes.
Deborah says most landlords are just trying to make themselves whole again and are not price gouging. Of course, that's little consolation to people like Barbara struggling to accept a rent hike that could force her to move.
Are we going to have to save to move?
Deborah's advice to tenants, be kind and negotiate. Most landlords would rather keep a good tenant than have to find a new one. So always don't waste your money. I'm John Matarese, 23 ABC.